I really wish I was at the AWS New York Summit today. They released a whole bunch of features that are really compelling, but I wanted to talk about one of them that I thought was particularly compelling, and that's the new feature in Bedrock called AgentCore. And so let me give you a little bit of a backstory. If you deploy agents, and we're deploying a lot of agents inside Amazon, we're deploying, you know, we have an AI-powered shopping assistant, we have Alexa Plus, we have a chatbot, and a whole host of others. And then, of course, we have a lot of companies that are building agents on top of AWS. When, you know, you can create those agents with tools like Strands or LangChain or AI Crew, but if you want to go deploy those in an enterprise-grade way, it's actually quite difficult. And it's really holding up customers, it's slowing them down. And in some cases, they're just not deploying. And so it reminds me in a lot of ways of the beginning of AWS, where we found inside the company that the vast majority of our developers were spending most of their time on the undifferentiated heavy lifting of infrastructure instead of what differentiated their feature. And so we tried to solve that problem by building primitive building blocks like compute and storage and database. And we realized the same thing applies to agents. And so that's what we've tried to provide you in this initial launch of AgentCore. We've got 6 building blocks I'm going to talk about, all of which I think are really compelling. The first of which is we've given you a secure serverless runtime. And so what you find today is that there are some folks that have these process level isolation options for you, but process level is not that secure. What you really want is for each user of your agent to have its own VM. And that's what we've built with our runtime capabilities, the same way that we isolate EC2 and Lambda. So it's a game changer for you in terms of secure runtime. And then if you're building an agent, you actually want to personalize the experience, but that means you need memory. So we've built a memory building block for you that lets you have both short and long-term memory. And then of course, you need to figure out how to manage identity and access control. And that's what we've provided you in a seamless way in our identity building block. And then one of the things you're going to want to do with your agent is you're going to want to connect to all sorts of APIs and resources out there to make your agent more functional. And so we've built a gateway for you that will do the translation from APIs or services into MCP compatible interfaces so that your agent can interact with any API or any service. Then we've also given you a series of built-in tools. So we have a code execution tool that allows you to do complex calculations, to process data, to actually bring up visuals. And then we've also given you a browser tool that will allow you to navigate the web, to do multi-step form completion, and then also to be able to take complex web actions. And then the last building block in this agent core for you is an observability one. So if you have an agent, you actually want to know what it's up to all the time. You want to see the steps it's taken. You want to see the actions it's taken. You want to be able to debug it. You want to understand the latency and the duration. All of those capabilities are available to you in that observability primitive. So if you look at AgentCore, between the secure runtime, memory, identity, a gateway, those built-in tools, and then observability, it completely changes the game in how you can deploy your agents in an enterprise-grade way. I'm really excited for you to have at it. Like any of our building blocks, just like at the beginning of AWS, we will continue to take your feedback and iterate really quickly, but I think this is going to be a game changer for you. I'm excited for you to have it. Giddy up.